The ability to use a proper full camera as a native webcam has been a sought-after feature since cameras stopped carrying native USB hosts for that themselves. For a while, there was only really one well-known and reliable solution, the Magewell XI100D USB, available in both HDMI and SDI variants. But recently, a few more companies have thrown their hats into the ring. I've already reviewed Elgato's Camlink, which serves this functionality at a budget price, but with quite a few features cut out compared to the Magewell, and now we have the AverMedia ExtremeCap UVC in the studio. In a future video, we'll also tackle a new company's attempt at this product concept, which has an Indiegogo campaign behind it. Let's take a look right after this.
They're behind us.
Who?
They have an Orisa.
Orisa? Where?
Don't go around the corner.
Huh?
You better don't.
I just see a rock. Oh. Cool. Dude, will you just get a mod mic already? It attaches to any headphone so you can use that good pair that you like, but I'll actually be able to understand your callouts. It also has a mute switch so that I don't hear all those darn conversations with your grandma. We gotta get serious if we're gonna get out of Platt. Yeah, just order one tonight. Head on over to antlionaudio.com to learn more and check it out.
You may proceed.
I'm Meeples Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and today we're taking a look at the AverMedia BU110, or the ExtremeCap UVC. As an added bonus, all of the A-roll for this video, that is, the footage of me talking right now, is being captured with this dongle. All of the source footage will be 1080p 60fps, but I will be creating this video at 2560 by 1440 to give the video more bandwidth so you can see a better representation of the quality of the video here on YouTube. If you're watching this off of YouTube, you might want to head over to see the best quality result. I uploaded some quality samples over the weekend straight from the Windows 10 camera app, RE Central 3, and OBS Studio. But again, YouTube crushes 1080p quality, so keep an eye on the gameplay here in full 1440p. This little device takes your HDMI sources, game consoles, cameras, computers, and so on, and allows them to show up on your computer as a native webcam. This is very much like a standard capture card or dongle, but it works using the native UVC drivers built into most operating systems, requiring no additional setup time or driver installation and allowing it to show up as a webcam in video chatting apps like Skype, Discord, and so on, which most capture cards cannot do. This little box features a HDMI input on one end, indicator LED along the top, and a USB Type-C 3.0 port on the other side. There's no HDMI pass-through, so you'll need an HDMI splitter if you're running a game console or need to preview your source in real time. This is a super low latency capture solution, but playing from a video preview in most games is still not quite real time enough to be an enjoyable experience for fast-paced games. Some people can do it, but just not. I don't recommend it. Also, as with other capture options that we have looked at, this card can support a max of 1080p 60fps. No higher than 1080p nor higher than 60Hz will be supported. You get a USB Type-C to Type-A cord in the box, but it works fine with a USB C-to-C cable for most devices as well. I wanted to actually touch on real quick that one of the key selling points for this device, and part of the reason it costs so much more than the Elgato Camlink, is that this works with mobile devices. I can't test this myself since I don't have a USB-C capable smartphone, but my buddy Lon Seidman and others have tested it, and the ExtremeCap UVC works great to connect to a smartphone and record or stream your camera on the go. This helps eliminate the need for many products, such as portable streaming boxes or even field monitors. You can use your phone as a basic monitor, quick external video recorder, or as a full-on broadcast unit, since YouTube now supports mobile live streaming. Just get a quick shoe mount to mount your phone to your camera or to whatever tripod rig you have, and you're good to go. As I just mentioned, AverMedia's unit is a bit pricey, costing roughly twice as much as Elgato's Camlink. But for that price, you get a couple important things. The mobile broadcasting capabilities I mentioned before, interlaced video support for the huge market of 1080i cameras out there, something the Elgato Camlink can't quite do for some reason, and it handles scaling of video sources and color space conversion on the chip inside the device itself. The Magewell dongle can do that plus handle some compression and encoding on the card for $50 more or so, but this is a great option. Handling scaling on the fly can seriously help reduce CPU loads for deinterlacing 1080i, scaling up 720p footage to 1080p, or 1080p down to 720p, and so on. I was messing around with deinterlacing settings in OBS Studio, and it would appear that the ExtremeCap UVC is doing deinterlacing within the card. Applying any deinterlacing modes in software or in editing software just makes the video look funky. Disabling it, it looks great. It's being deinterlaced on the fly. How many times can I say deinterlacing in one video? The scaling features can be seen specifically in the Windows 10 camera app, as well as OBS Studio or whatever streaming app's configuration, where you have multiple resolution and frame rate options for the device. Whereas with the Elgato Cam Link, you only have the source spec available. You can only choose 1080p 60 if it's a 1080p 60 signal. This is great. But if you are just bringing in native 720p or 1080p sources to a PC, the Elgato Cam Link will do what you want for half the price, so probably go with that. Now, you are getting an uncompressed video feed from this device. This is good for most modern use cases, as you don't want your computer to have to decompress a compressed video feed and then recompress it for streaming while the whole thing is going, and this is super low latency as a result, but can mean slower machines struggle to handle the video feed. Plus, it uses up a lot of bandwidth on the USB bus, so if you're using more than one of these dongles at a time, you'll have to be careful as to which USB buses you are using. The dongle itself is super hefty and durable feeling. I believe the frame is made out of aluminum. It will survive well for event travel and such like that. In fact, you might have to be careful not to let it scratch up your other gear. Having my Magewell card on top of it and moving it around when I was going to shoot B-roll and things like that resulted in some of the plastic or the paint coming off of the Magewell onto the ExtremeCap UVC. That was a little weird and kind of concerning at first. The case acts as a heatsink too to keep it cool. It does not get very hot during use. My X99 era desktop has wonky USB-C support, so running C2C on the ExtremeCap UVC resulted in some glitchy video in Windows 10's camera app, but it showed up fine in everything else. Running the normal C2A USB cable worked fine with all apps, and the C2C to my laptop worked fine as well. The device works in Windows, Mac, and Linux, though I can only test it in Windows and Linux. It worked with OBS, the camera app, dedicated video chatting apps like Skype and Discord, OBS Studio, and other streaming programs. And it even works in AverMedia's own game capture program, RE Central 3, so you have options here. In OBS, there might be some delay or desync issues, so they've updated it now to show two listings after you've had it plugged in for a while. It didn't show up initially for me. There's the basic device, which just says ExtremeCap UVC, and then there's the ExtremeCap UVC streaming engine. This works much like the LiveGamer HD2 I reviewed a while back. The streaming engine device gives a more direct access to the video feed to stay in sync and low latency. In OBS specifically, you'll want to enable a custom audio device for the ExtremeCap and choose the ExtremeCap UAC audio option too. Otherwise, it won't bring in any audio at all. It's a little weird. AverMedia's cards are a little weird in OBS. Uncompressed, low latency, UVC compatible capture for game consoles, cameras, camcorders, and PCs. The ExtremeCap UVC comes at a more premium price compared to something like Elgato's option, but comes with much more desirable features from the professional and more expensive market. Affiliate product links will be in the description below, as always. Hit the like button if you enjoyed this review. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm EposVox, and I will see you in the next one. EposVox is a Patreon-supported production. Our videos would simply not be possible without the support and generosity of our patrons, whom you can see on screen now. If you'd like to join the inner circle and get early access to videos, among other benefits, go to patreon.com/eposvox to learn more.